saw the pretty sailor lad who ploughed the stormy sea. He dressed himself in tarry clothes like one in poverty. His pockets being well lined, the wealth could save the trade. For to try the heart of Mary Ann, little lowland maid. As Mary Ann was standing down by her cottage door, she frowned upon the sailor lad who seemed to be so poor. She looked just like a goddess in a jewel rich array, but the thorn was in the blossom of little lowland maid. Good morning, said was Mary Ann, I'm glad to meet with you. Have you forgot your own true love, or changed your love for new? Or is your inclination all lonesome of stray? So be gone, said lovely Mary Ann, little lowland maid. She seemed to be so scornful that the sailor said, behold, all from shrouds of pocket save all the black gold. So then replied was Mary Ann, excuse me, love, I said, you're welcome to the cottage and the little lowland maid. Oh, no deceitful damsel, your falseness shall be paid, for I can light and warn it in some distant barn or shed. It was the hour of 12 o'clock, in Mary Ann astray, for to tell some other comrade where the sailor he did lay. They went with their black lanterns and their daggers in their hands. They rode through fields and meadows and past the muddy lands. Cheer up your hearts, said Mary Ann, do not be dismayed. We will rob and slay the sailor for little lowland maid. They both then plunged their daggers into the sailor deep. They robbed him of his glittering gold and left him there to weep. A gamekeeper was watching them from his ward to strike, for to swear against the villain and the little lowland maid. Trials and were condemned and cast, and from the faithful gallows trees they both were hung at last. Thou